Hi, my name is David Slade. I am the director of the Twilight Saga Eclipse. And what we're going to be showing you here is some extended scenes that are already in the film, but just stuff we cut down shorter that we liked longer. So we just thought we'd let you see that. And also some scenes that we actually had to cut out of the film altogether. When you're making a film, it kind of sets its own pace. It's not like you're trying to hit a time, but it's an organic growing thing, and it kind of tells you how long it should be. It kind of establishes its own pace, and so sometimes you get these wonderful scenes that you totally love, and you just have to, unfortunately, just take them out. So here we're taking these things we love, and we're rather than throwing them away completely, we're actually putting them on the DVD for you to see.
So the University of Washington sent me and Eric our dorm assignments yesterday. I'm in the furthest dorm from campus. Eric's in the closest one, of course. Something wrong?
No. Why?
Well, one, Edward's always with you, and two, you keep looking out that window like you're hoping he'll show up and serenade you or something.
Doubtful.
Okay, we don't have to talk about it.
No, it's nothing. I mean, it is, but. Okay. You remember Jacob Black?
Oh, okay. So, Edward's jealous.
You say that like it's really obvious.
Isn't it? I've seen the way Jacob looks at you. Edward's seen it too. He's only human. He's gonna act like any other guy.
I think it's a little more complicated.
Say the words, Bella. Jealousy.
I've told Jake how I feel. He understands.
Okay. So the word's denial.
You saying I'm an idiot?
Oh, just a little oblivious.
What? I mean, every move I make hurts someone.
Bella, they're big boys. They make their own choices. Seriously, don't worry about it. It'll work itself out. It's not life or death.
Yeah.
So make as many mistakes as you can. That way someday when they ask what we want to be, we won't have to guess. We'll know.
Oh, I'm proud of you, Bells. Can't wait to see what you're going to do next. You're my biggest accomplishment.
It's not true.
Yes, it is. Well, you'll see one day when you have kids.
I want you to be happy. I'll understand if you're too angry for me to come to your room tonight. Just keep the window closed.
Whoever it was, he left his stink behind. It'll be hard to miss when we cross it again. We'll handle it from here.
We don't need you to handle anything. or anyone.
I could care less what you need.
Okay, great. Then we'll all work together. Come on, we've all got the same goals here, right? To catch the bad vampires.
Like there's a difference.
All right. We're done here.
No, you're done here.
Stop! Let go! I'm tired of this. From now on, I'm Switzerland, okay? I know you guys don't like each other, but we've got bigger problems. Lots of them. And this is just one temporary solution. If you'd be willing to try.
Seattle is in a state of terror. Police are baffled by the escalating murders and disappearances. Theories range from a vicious new gang to a wildly active serial killer. Reporting live, Don Chube, CNN.
It's getting worse. We might have to do something.
It takes more than one of our kind to cause the damage they're reporting. Quite a few more. And they're undisciplined, conspicuous.
It's newborns.
What, like new vampires?
In the first few months after the change.
That's when we're at our most uncontrollable, vicious, insane with thirst.
Something to look forward to.
No one's trained these newborns, but this isn't random.
Someone's creating an army.
Well, now we're definitely going to Seattle.
An army of vampires?
And they'd be created to fight someone.
We're the only clan even close to Seattle.
Regardless of why they were made, if we don't put a stop to them, the Volturi will. I'm surprised they've let it go on this long.
Well, maybe they're ignoring it. Maybe they're behind it. In Italy, I read Arrow's mind. He tried to hide it, but I saw. He wants me and Alice to join him. He thinks our gifts would add to his power. But he knows we'll never choose him as long as our family is still alive.
An army could solve that for him.
Edward, I don't think that we should wait until graduation. I think you should change me now.
Bella, no.
I'm a liability now. I could be an asset.
You'd be a bigger liability as a newborn. Unable to control your instincts. An easy target.
There's also your father to consider. And your mother. Imagine how terrible it would be for them if you suddenly disappeared.
But we're still gonna kick someone's ass, right?
Go blather to someone else about the joys of becoming a newborn. Okay. Rosalie. I don't understand what I did to make you hate me so much.
Hate?
I don't hate you.
I don't particularly like you. Bella, I envy you.
What? That's ridiculous.
No, it's not. You have a choice. I didn't. None of us did, but you do, and you're choosing wrong. I don't care how miserable your human life is.
My life is not miserable. It's not perfect. And nobody's life is perfect.
Mine was. Absolutely perfect. There were things I still wanted. To be married with a nice house and a husband to kiss me when he came home. But mostly I wanted a baby.
He never cried.
So much. Aren't you just the best little boy ever? Royce King was the most eligible bachelor in town. I barely knew him. We were never alone. But I was young. I was in love with the idea of love.
What did I say about a low profile? Something's coming. Something bigger than any of us alone. And if you can't control yourselves, we're all going to die. But together, we can crush anything. Do you understand? Do you understand? Now, what's done is done. Just clean up after yourselves.
You saw?
No. Jacob's thoughts are pretty loud.
I don't know what happened.
You love him.
I love you more.
I know. When I left you bleeding. And Jacob stitched you up. Just left its mark on both of you. And that's my fault.
Don't blame yourself.
I just want you to be happy. No matter how.